Good morning and welcome to worship with St. Barnabas Lutheran Church. My name is Pastor Jeff Heiderscheidt. I know for some of you it's the first time you're seeing my face. I wish we could be together today on this first Sunday with you, but we hope that this video worship service is a way that draws the Lord closer to your life today. We'll be doing video worship from here on out, and we'll be modifying it and honing it as we go. There is a downloadable pages that you could download and follow along. Our hope is that in the future we will have as much of it on the screen following along as you participate, so we get it as easy for you as possible. Today, I come to you today as one who knows that it has been a season of much change in your congregation. I know Pastor Amber's last day was Friday, and a couple weeks ago you said farewell to Pastor Wayne, and then now here's the new guys. So I know your head must be swimming with all the changes that you've had, but please know that I'm excited to be here, and we'll walk this journey together. Today is the day that the Lord has made. Let us rejoice and be glad in it, and we will begin today with our opening hymn. Please sing along with us.
We begin in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our God, we your people stand ready and open to receive the flame of your Spirit. Give us the ability to speak your truth so that others may hear.
Come, Spirit of truth, fill our hearts.
May that which was of stone be now transformed into life.
Come, Spirit of life. Change our hearts.
May we who receive your light dwell together in your love.
Come, Spirit of love, soften our hearts.
Bestow your compassion on those who suffer in mind, spirit, and body.
Come, Spirit of hope, heal our hearts.
Make us bold to bring light to the dark places, warmth to the cold places, and love to the empty places.
Come, Spirit of faith, strengthen our hearts.
Spirit of the living God, fill our hearts, minds, and souls to overflowing.
Come, Spirit of God, move in our hearts.
O God, we, your people, celebrate the mystery of your never-ending love.
Amen.
We stand at the font today as we give our confession and forgiveness, and we're reminded that we are surrounded by God's love. Through the waters of our baptism, we are accepted by God. So we come before God in joy and confession. O Lord, knowing your love and grace, we know we are safe to confess to you our sins. We also lay down before you the burdens of our soul, our brokenness and sadness over our losses. Restore in us the joy of salvation and oneness with you, ourselves and others. Raise us to new hope for your promised future. Let us take a moment of silent confession. Hear God's response of grace. Beloved child of God, because of Jesus Christ, your sins are forgiven. You are loved. This is hope in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. And let us pray. Lord God, you have called your servants to ventures of which we cannot see the ending. By paths yet untrodden, through perils unknown, give us faith to go out in good courage, not knowing where we go, but only that your hand is leading us and your love supporting us. Through Jesus Christ, who is our Lord. Amen.
Our Old Testament reading is from Isaiah 55. Ho, everyone who thirsts, come to the waters. And you that have no money, come, buy and eat. Come, buy wine and milk without money and without price. Why do you spend your money for that which is not bread, and your labor for that which does not satisfy? Listen carefully to me, and eat what is good, and delight yourselves in rich food. Incline your ear and come to me. Listen, so that you may live. I will make with you an everlasting covenant, my steadfast, sure love for David. See, I made him a witness to the peoples, a leader and a commander for the peoples. See, you shall call nations that you do not know, and nations that do not know you shall run to you, because of the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, for he has glorified you. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God.
Psalm 145. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger and abounding in steadfast love. Lord, you are good to all, and your compassion is over all your works. The Lord upholds all those who fall, and lifts up those who are bowed down. The eyes of all wait upon you, O Lord, and you give them their food in due season. You open wide your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. You are righteous in all your ways and loving in all your works. You are near to all who call upon you, to all who call up on you faithfully. You fulfill the desire of those who fear you. You hear their cry and save them. You watch over all those who love you, but all the wicked you shall destroy. My mouth shall speak the praise of the Lord. Let all flesh press God's holy name forever and ever.
The New Testament reading comes from Romans chapter 9, verses 1 through 5. I am speaking the truth in Christ. I am not lying. My conscience confirms it by the Holy Spirit. I have great sorrow and unceasing anguish in my heart. For I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites, and to them belong the adoption, the glory, the covenants, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. To them belong the patriarchs, and from them, according to the flesh, comes the Messiah, who is over all, God blessed forever. Amen. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Our Holy Gospel today is the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 14, verses 13 through 21. Glory to you, O Lord. Now when Jesus heard about the beheading of John the Baptist, he withdrew from there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the towns. When he went ashore, he saw great crowds, and he had compassion for them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is now late. Send the crowds away so that they may go into the village and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." They replied, "We have nothing here but 5 loaves and 2 fish. And Jesus said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke the loaves and gave them to the disciples, and the disciples gave them to the crowds. And all ate and were filled, and they took up what was left over of the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men besides the women and children. This is the gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Well, grace and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. There's a story of an old man who goes to a diner every day for lunch, and each day he orders the soup and 2 slices of bread. One day the manager asks him how he liked his meal. The old man replied, "It was good, but I could go for a little more bread." So the next day, the manager tells the waitress to give him 4 slices of bread. "How was your meal today, sir?" the manager asks. "It was good, but I could use a little more bread," comes the reply. So the next day, the manager tells the waitress to give him 8 slices of bread. "How was your meal today, sir?" the manager asks. "Good, but you could give me a little more bread," comes the reply. The manager is now obsessed with seeing that this customer is satisfied with his meal. So he goes to the bakery and he orders one of those 6-foot-long loaves of bread that you see in the party subs. When the man comes in, as usual the next day, the waitress and the manager cut the loaf in half, butter the entire length of each half, and lay it on the counter right next to the man's bowl of soup. Well, the old man sits down and devours both the bowl of soup and both halves of this 6-foot-long loaf of bread. The manager asks him now, "Sir, how was your meal today?" The old man replied, "It was good as usual, but I see that you're back to giving me only 2 slices of bread. Hunger. That word, it could mean so many things. Maybe desires or yearnings are better words to attach to it. I don't know of anyone who doesn't have some sort of desire or hunger during this time of COVID-19. We are all hungering and yearning for something. I don't know about you, but I am. I'm yearning for the time when we can all gather together as community in one place to be together, to learn each other's names and see each other's faces. We're hungering, we're yearning. Hunger's come in all shapes and sizes. For some people, hunger is the desire of popularity, to be noticed and liked on Facebook or Instagram or the TikTok videos or maybe even YouTube. Everything they do is geared toward being seen or being watched. The more they gain recognition, the more they want to be in the spotlight. But they seem to be chasing something that they just cannot catch. There are some who desire the need to be accepted. Maybe whether it's because of a low self-esteem, or maybe they just feel forgotten and invisible. And so they grasp on to anything that seems to be the in trend, anything that will get them to be accepted. And maybe even their morals shift to whatever will bring them into that inner circle of a friendship with someone. There are some who desire success at work. They're burning the candle at both ends, and they're often doing it at great cost to their family and friends and even their own health. For others, it's the hunger for the perfect life, or maybe it's the perfect body weight or the perfect family. No matter what we do or where we search for answers, the meaning here on earth, our desires ultimately go unfed. The more we get, the more we want. If a little is good, more must be better. We think something is going to fill that empty space. My father-in-law owned a boat. He was so excited to get the boat, and he told me that his most exciting 2 days of the boat were the day he got it and the day he sold it, right? I ask you this day, what is it that you desire? Deep down, what is the hunger in you that yearns to be filled? And what is it that you are trying to fill it with? As I ponder this, the scripture verse from Deuteronomy 8 rings in my ears. One does not live by bread alone, but from every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. I imagine Deuteronomy was ringing in Jesus' ears on this particular day as well. Today's miracle of the feeding of the 5,000 plus is a story about people with deep desires who are finding satisfaction. It's a mysterious miracle. There is much that seems to be left out of this story that we want to have answered. It's unclear to us as to what the blessed and broken food looked like while it was being distributed. It would be interesting to know just exactly how much it grew. How much did people really eat? All we know is that 12 baskets of leftovers were remaining from these two little fish and five loaves of bread. Now, over time, there have been a number of attempts to explain the miracle. One attempt says that the people who were with Jesus were so moved by his generosity and teaching that they brought out from under their garments the food that they would have had for their own circle of family, and they shared it with everyone around them. This way, everyone was satisfied. Another theory says that the story is not talking about physical hunger at all, but it's spiritual hunger. When the small amount of food was passed around, everyone tore off this minuscule little symbolic fragment, and this Jesus is said to have satisfied the thirst of the soul, not the stomach. It's interesting to note that this is the only miracle that made it in all four of the Gospels. So it must be important, and there must be a message for us to hear. On that day, just above the shorelines of the Sea of Galilee, on a grassy hill stands Jesus with so many before him. He's at the height of his popularity. He had been healing many who were sick and afflicted with illnesses and demons. On that beautiful day, he reached out to more than he had ever done before. In fact, it was the largest gathering of people that he helped all at one time. Everybody seemingly walked away with something on that day. I'm sure he knew it was going to be a moving event, but he was also aware that he was going to be courting danger. He would be alerting the common town folk all over the land that he was the long-awaited Messiah. This would be a challenge to the religious authorities and even a challenge to Rome, since the Messiah was to be the King of Israel. And ultimately, this would be a challenge to the crowds as well. Would they understand who this Jesus actually is to them? I can almost hear the disciples, "Jesus, what do you mean, give them something to eat? We only have 5 small loaves of bread and 2 little fish." "These are the facts, Jesus. 5 and 2, no more, no less. Send the 5,000 plus people home. We can't take care of them today." But like all of us, the apostles are subject to the laws of facts that govern the world, but God is not. Now, I do not mean that we can at any time just call upon God and God will override the natural laws, but what I suggest to you today is that where Jesus is present, no fact, no matter is indisputable. God will accomplish God's plan, and God will meet needs. What are we to learn from this big miracle today? It's simply this, that God can turn our hungers and our desires into satisfaction, and not in the way that anyone would think. God's satisfaction comes when we find our home in Him. There's an old saying that everyone has a God-shaped hole in their lives and only God can fill it. That is true. What are we to learn from this long-awaited Messiah? We learn that Jesus is indeed the fulfillment of the Word of God. Oh, how long the Israelites had waited for the Messiah to come. It had been centuries, 4 centuries to be exact, since the last prophet had spoken in the land. It was Malachi calling a troubled nation to repent 400 years before Jesus would walk the earth. It had been longer still, 1,000 years since Israel and Judah had a leader like King David or King Solomon. And it was 1,500 years since Moses. The scriptures were alive in the lives of the Jewish people. As children, they grew up hearing the stories of their ancestors and being told that one day God would send the Messiah who would fulfill the promises of all of those years. All 5,000 men plus those women and children gathered to hear Jesus, and they were asking the same question, "Is this the one? Is this the Messiah? Or is it just another prophet?" And then the sun began to set, and the end of the day drew near, and they listened and followed for hours. And now it was time for dinner, and the disciples, perhaps out of care for their master or feeling kind of hungry and hangry themselves, they want to send the people away. But Jesus surprises his disciples, asking them to feed the crowd. Now, there were many occasions when the disciples responded like any of us would respond. "We have here only 5 loaves of bread and 2 fish. But Jesus offered an opportunity for the 12 to see God at work, to see something other than the world that they had come to know and understand. He asked for the food. He blessed it and broke it again and again. And then the people began to understand. This is the one whom the prophets of old had spoken. The Messiah would come in the spirit of the prophets of old. That is what the people had been told. It was clear to all that this man was fulfilling the word of the Lord. This was God's messenger, the one who would come not to grant our every whim, but rather the one who would satisfy our deepest hurting hungers. Jesus steps into their lives and brings the past and the Old Testament past to life. He is the law and the prophets incarnate. The old stories breathed to life again. In a word, he is the fulfillment. Yes, in him even we are filled. In Christ, our hearts find a home. He is the great hunger healer. And for you today, he is the bread of life. Yes, during this time and this craziness of COVID-19, may you find the peace that passes all understanding in the knowledge that God does care for you. God does care for your future, for your present, here and now, and always. God is the fulfillment for you. We want to thank you for your giving and support of St. Barnabas Lutheran Church. It helps us to continue our ministry here and God's ministry in the world. So any way that you are able to give, you can mail in checks to the office, or you could send it by your bank PayPal, or there's all sorts of ways that you could do it. We receive it graciously, and please know that it does go for God's mission in the world. So at this time, you know, we just ask that you prayerfully consider how you are able to support St. Barnabas in the ministry, and we want to say thank you for what you have already done. So let us pray an offertory prayer. Trustworthy Lord, you have entrusted us with all we need, not only to live, but also to share. We offer with joy and thanksgiving what you have first given us. Accept our offerings by which your good work is done, here among us and out in the world of need. Amen.
Confident of God's care and helped by the Holy Spirit, we pray for the church, the world, and all who are in need. Lord God, you take resources that appear to be meager, bless them, and there is enough. May your church trust that which you bless and ask us to share with the world is abundantly sufficient. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord God, open your hand and satisfy the desire of every living thing. Hear the anguish of tender hearts who cry to you in suffering and satisfy their deepest needs. Bring wholeness and healing to those who suffer in body, heart, soul, and mind. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Almighty God, you offer freely the gift of salvation. Give our congregation of St. Barnabas Lutheran such a welcoming heart that our words and actions may extend your free and abundant hospitality to all whom we encounter. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Creator God, you are the great physician who brings healing and wholeness where there is brokenness and despair. Lift up those who cry out to you in their fear and worries. Grant protection to those serving on the front lines of our pandemic, and grant a renewed spirit to those who have been ill from this virus. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Receive these prayers, O God, and those too deep for words. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Please join us in the words Jesus taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Jesus lives again when we forget who has.
people of God, receive the benediction. The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord's face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord look upon you with favor and give you peace. In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Go in peace and serve the Lord. Thanks be to God.